Hey everyone, it's Bola from Binance and welcome back to the Binance Studios. In this video, we're diving into cryptography, the art and science of protecting information. Without cryptography, there'd be no Bitcoin, no blockchains, no secure wallets, and definitely no privacy online. So let's break it down. Did you know that cryptography has been around for over 4,000 years? The first known encrypted message was not on a computer, not even on paper. Back in ancient Mesopotamia, a pottery maker encoded his secret glaze formula on a clay tablet, a basic code to keep trade secrets, well, secret. The Greeks later invented the Scytale, a wooden tool used to wrap messages around a cylinder so only someone with a matching one could decode it. And in ancient Rome, Julius Caesar popularized what's now known as the Caesar cipher, replacing each letter in a message with another, shifted by a few spaces in the alphabet. Simple, yes, but revolutionary because it laid the groundwork for modern encryption. As time went on, code breakers got smarter, and so did encryption. In the 800s, Arab mathematician Al-Kindi invented frequency analysis to crack basic ciphers. And in 1465, Leon Alberti introduced the polyalphabetic cipher using multiple alphabets to confuse attackers. By 1623, Francis Bacon developed binary encoding, an early step towards computers. And then came a game changer. Thomas Jefferson's cipher wheel in the 1700s used rotating rings to create thousands of code combinations, so good that the US military used it in the 20th century. And in World War II, encryption reached a turning point with the Enigma machine, so complex that it took early computers to crack it, helping end the war. With computers came powerful encryption, like 128-bit keys protecting everything from emails to online banking. And today, cryptocurrencies are built on it. Let's unpack the cryptography behind crypto. Most blockchains use something called public key cryptography, also known as asymmetric cryptography. It's a system that uses two keys, a public key, which anyone can see or use to send you encrypted information, and a private key, which only you hold and use to unlock access to move your crypto. They're mathematically linked, but you can't guess one from the other. And that's what makes it extremely secure, even over open networks. The most common algorithm behind this? Well, it's called the RSA, and that was developed in 1977. It forms the basis of secure systems that we use every day, from online banking to encrypted emails. Now, here's where it gets interesting. With public key cryptography, we can also generate digital signatures, like a virtual fingerprint, proving that you signed or approved a transaction without revealing your private key. So when you create a crypto wallet, your public key generates your wallet address, and your private key lets you move funds and create digital signatures to verify each transaction. Once verified, the transaction is added to the blockchain. Bitcoin and Ethereum both use a specific cryptographic standard called ECDSA, the Elliptic Curve Digital Signature Algorithm. It's fast, it's secure, and it doesn't require a traditional encryption, which is why crypto still works, even on an open, transparent ledger. Even though public key cryptography is powerful, it's not perfect. It's slower than symmetric cryptography when handling large data. And if you lose your private key, your access is gone. And if it's leaked, anyone can impersonate you or move your funds. Fast forward to today, and researchers are exploring quantum cryptography, which could one day be resistant to even the most powerful computers, ensuring security for decades to come. So let's recap. Cryptography began as a way to protect information 4,000 years ago. It evolved through war, science, and early computing. Today, it secures blockchains, crypto wallets, and every Bitcoin that you send. And the future? It's being built on stronger, faster, smarter encryption. So the next time that you sent crypto, remember that there's thousands of years of innovation behind that one transaction. Well, that's it for today's video. And let us know in the comments what part of cryptography surprised you the most. And if you want to learn more, check out Binance Academy because the link is right down in the description box. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.